Before long, another death is discovered, and this time there seems to be no doubt that the victim was murdered. Yet, in a Golden Age detective novel, things are seldom as they seem. These Names Make Clues is an example of the traditional closed circle mystery, with a limited group of suspects, as with Bats in the Belfry, which Lorac published earlier the same year, and which has been reprinted as a British Library crime classic. For those tempted to indulge in a little literary detection, it seems highly significant that 1937 was also the year in which E.C.R. Lorac was elected to membership of the Detection Club. The Detection Club was the world's first social network for detective novelists. Founded in 1930 by Anthony Barclay, the club adopted a constitution and formal rules a couple of years later, by which time it had already made a significant impression on the literary world, broadcasting two radio serial mysteries and publishing two highly successful collaborative detective novels, The Floating Admiral and Ask a Policeman, which remain in print to this day. The first president was G.K. Chesterton. After his death in 1936, he was succeeded by E.C. Bentley, author of Trent's Last Case, the novel which was the catalyst for the Golden Age style of cerebral whodunit. Leading figures in the club included Dorothy L. Sayers, Father Ronald Knox, John Rode, Agatha Christie, Millward Kennedy, and Baroness Orczy. The aim of the club was primarily social, but members were also keen to elevate the literary standards of the genre. Election to membership was, and remains to this day, highly prized. Lorac was elected the year after the club elected its first American member, John Dixon Carr. In the same year, she was joined by Christopher Bush, Newton Gale, a pen name for Morris Guinness and Mona Lee, and Nicholas Blake, the name under which Cecil Day Lewis, who later became Poet Laureate, wrote detective fiction.